Give peace, O Lord, to those who wait for you. Hear the prayers of your servants and guide us in the way of justice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Good afternoon. Brothers and sisters, as we gather to celebrate Mass on this Memorial Day, let us first pause and call to mind our sins and ask God for his forgiveness.
I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who have revealed that peacemakers are to be called your children, grant, we pray, that we may work without ceasing to establish that justice which alone ensures true and lasting peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled through the interior of the country and down to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They answered him, "We have never even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." He said, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 men. He entered the synagogue, and for 3 months debated boldly with persuasive arguments about the kingdom of God. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven. As wax melts before the fire.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
But the just rejoice and exalt before God. They are glad and rejoice. Sing to God, chant praise to his name, whose name is the Lord.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
The Father of disciples said to Jesus, "Now you are talking plainly and not in any figurative speech. Now we realize that you know everything and you do not need to have anyone question you. Because of this, we believe that you came from God." Jesus answered them, "Do you believe now? Behold, the hour is coming, and has arrived, when each of you will be scattered in his own home, and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you this, so that you might have peace in me. In the world you will have trouble, but take courage. I have conquered the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This Memorial Day, we're still in the Easter season, so our readings from the seventh week of Easter. Our first reading from Acts of the Apostles, Paul asks the people that he's speaking to in Corinth, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then told them that John baptized with a baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus. When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them. So understand why John is asking them, "How were you baptized?" We have to go a little bit earlier in Acts of the Apostles. We actually go to when Paul was not yet Paul. His name was Saul. And he was Jewish. He was a Pharisee. And he was persecuting the Christians. In fact, he was there standing when St. Stephen was stoned to death. But then his conversion, as he was traveling to Damascus, he was blinded by this bright light. And then he heard a voice say to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Now the question assumes that Saul knows who's speaking to him. It turns out to be Jesus that is saying to Saul, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" But Jesus had already died on the cross. He had already risen from the dead. He had already ascended into heaven. When this takes place with Saul, his conversion. And the reason that is important is because Saul never personally persecuted Jesus. So why would Jesus say, "Why are you persecuting me?" And the understanding is in baptism. Because once Jesus was baptized in the Jordan, no longer did we have a baptism of repentance, which John was preaching. But with Jesus' baptism to ours today, we understand baptism as dying with Christ and rising with him. We understand in our baptism that we become a new creation. We become members of the body of Christ, and Christ is our head. And so when Saul was persecuting the early church, when Saul was persecuting Christians, he was persecuting Jesus. Because you can't separate the head from the body. Yes, we are many parts, though one body. remembering those who served our country initially in the Civil War. But now a day in which we honor all the men and women who have served our country, and particularly those who have died serving our country. We also now traditionally remember our loved ones who have died as well on Memorial Day. But just as Jesus did what he did for the body of Christ, for us, servicemen and women did what they did, willing to die for our country, for our freedoms, for the very things we cherish as human beings, particularly as Americans. But as we heard in our gospel acclamation, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above. Though we are here on earth, we need to keep our eyes on heaven, because that's our ultimate destiny. We were not created just for this life. We were created by God to know him, to love him, to serve him, but ultimately to be with him forever in heaven. That's our ultimate destiny. And that's what should always motivate us in how we live life here. Are our words and our actions such that people would recognize we're keeping our eyes on heaven in what we say and what we do? Seek what is above. The men and women who served our country, those men and women who served and died, there's the adage, there's no atheism in a foxhole. They did what they did, not only because of their belief in what our country stands for, they did what they did because of their faith and their trust in God. They were seeking what is above. May we too always seek what is above. Amen. Trusting that God hears our prayers, we offer him our prayers of petition.
For the church, that through her teaching and preaching ministry, she may bring all her children to eternal life by knowledge of true God and the one whom he has sent, our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whom the Father has given Christ out of the world, may shine throughout the nations as a witness to a culture of life and a civilization of love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may devote ourselves to prayer and faith.
Mass, which is offered for the repose of the soul of Dean Kupta, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And gracious God, we place our prayers before you this day. We ask that if it be your will that you hear and answer them through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and
all his holy good. O God, may the saving sacrifice of your Son, the King of Peace, offered under sacramental signs that signify peace and unity, strengthen, we pray, O Lord, concord among all your children through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John the Baptist, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. Our prayer for an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Communion will be in a single line. We'll start on the south sections with the center section, and then those in the south traditionally come from the back, and then we'll switch to the north side.
Thank you.
sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Let us pray. Bestow on us, we pray, O Lord, the spirit of charity, so that sustained by the body and blood of your only begotten Son, we may be effective in nurturing among all the peace that he has left us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Please join. You'll know this one by heart. Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for ever waves of grain, for her, O mountain majesties, hallowed of fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Oh, beautiful for pilgrim feet who stirred in passion stress, a thoroughfare for freedom beat across the wilderness. America, America, God bend thine every flaw. Confirm thy soul in self-control, thy liberty in law. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Because there are no services in our cemeteries this year, we wanted to take this opportunity at this Mass to pray for those servicemen and women who are buried in St. John's Cemetery. Elbers David D. Elbers Robert. Elbers Roman J. Anderson Peter H. Blaschke Benedict. Bungie Russell J. Bushelman Cletus A. Deal Dr. John W. Deach Frank J. Icock Frank A. Felber Hubert H. Fallmeyer Kenneth L. Johnson Albert L. Kaiser Raymond S. Cook Cletus L. Cook George F. Lammers Norman G. Lammers Robert. Lanning Omar H. Lanning Virgil A. Naker Donald C. Pop Stevens, Jeremiah, J. Sudbeck, Joseph, J. Taney, John, H. Taney, Marcus, F. Tramp, Harold, C. Ewing, Andrew, J. Wyatt, Raphael DeSalas. Walters, Arlen J. Weeblehouse, Charles H. Weeblehouse, Donovan B. Weeblehouse, Daniel L. Buried at Sea, Dickus, Ruff. Rothluber, Lawrence. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon them.
May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Thank you and have a blessed memorial.